Hello.
Welcome.
It's my brother Andrew.
How are we doing?
Amanda Hunt sent us this down in a beer mail. I was away when this came out. I was in America. Andrew was working hard. Everybody else was drinking this.
Yeah.
so we didn't get a chance to try it. I'll show you this. Each Andrew opens the bottle. Each beer is different every year. The 2012 vintage ale, 16th, is brewed with three of this year's finest top varieties, including Goldings, award-winning Sovereign, and Target hops. These combined with our unique yeast and organic barley grown by Sir James Fuller on the Neston Park Estate, result in a wonderful limited edition brew that has a luxurious flavour. Individually packed and numbered, this bottle is one of only 125,000 produced. Although we are obliged to state a best before date of 2015, like a fine wine or whiskey, this mellow golden ale will improve with age. For many years, being bottle conditioned, the beer will form a natural sediment, so pour carefully, sit back and enjoy this. The very finest of Fuller's ales.
So
it's a very orange beer.
Well, it says here something about Sir James Fuller.
Yeah, just wrote. Why you listen to anything I say? Just read all that off the internet.
Yeah, but you're like. What was that?
I tried to get it out of the way as quick as possible.
When you said it, I was like, I won't even not take a notice because you're just like.
Trying to get it out of the way as quick as possible. But it's very orangey. It's orange.
Mm.
It almost looks like Iron Brew. Yeah, look, doesn't it?
I don't know. We had the Iron Brew.
Yeah, sure.
For Maxon.
Yeah. But it's orange, though, isn't it, though?
Yeah, is that the Goldings that they're putting in?
Put me to the big bottle, I've got it in bigger print over here.
No, so you said they put Goldings in, didn't they?
Yeah, varieties including Goldings, award-winning Sovereign and Target Ops.
So someone told me that...
I know, Sovereign, wasn't that like a British version?
Well, the Marston's Sovereign.
Yeah. Masters, we had one there, Sovereign, and we had the Goldings version as well, didn't we?
Is it me or it smells like blackcurrants? I can smell those blackcurrants. Can you smell blackcurrants?
I smell more.
Or redcurrants, or is it blackcurrants or redcurrants or something?
Yeah, there might be.
Now I have to really have a good whiff.
Is there much left?
There's a
pod more in.
A bit more. It's got a bigger body.
Yeah, bigger body, more of the aroma.
There. I get more of the malt.
Yeah, blackcurrants.
Well, it's like you say, it's like a blackcurrant.
And so, we seem to have been having the beers we had tonight. A lot of them have smelt like one peas and two peas.
Mm.
And brown bread. But they're all the similar variety, the gold beers.
Mm. And this one smells like blackcurrants, I think. Either blackcurrants or redcurrants.
There's almost a burnt toffee.
Well, I'm still getting blackcurrants.
It smells nice anyway.
Almost recognize
it's like a sweet blackberry treacle tart.
I mean, I'll recognize it as what you know, like, you know, what's that
it actually tastes like blackberry tart as well. Without getting all over your face,
yeah, it does.
It's just like a blackberry treacle tart. Actually, that sounds quite nice. Dessert, actually. Mm.
Don't know,
I guess.
A little tart.
I really fancy a blackberry treacle tart now.
Forget that and compare it.
No.
But no, yeah.
Slightly sticky as well.
I'd say.
In the smell.
On the taste, it's more of a black fruit tart. Like you get a black forest fruit, you know what I mean? And a type of jam.
I think that's what you get with the Goldings, actually.
A mellow golden ale.
To be fair, it's really drinkable. I forgot what the other Fuller's beers we do. They do. Just 1 second. Just find it. Someone's told me that this is it's an altered recipe of another recipe.
They don't really say what ingredients on it, so.
The problem is with having so many different beers all over the world. Let's look. Because I've been told that this is a different beer.
It might be a taste of elderberry, I don't know. But yeah, I definitely get a blackcurrant smell. Then you got a blackberry, like a blackberry tart, you said, you know what I mean? But other than that, it's not too bad. You can drink it, it's easy enough.
I can't remember what it reminds me of. 1845.
What's that?
1845 is what I've been told. It's the baseline recipe is the 1845, and then they alter the 1845 recipe.
Oh, right. So the idea behind it would be based from 1845 and just mature it a bit more.
Might be, yeah.
So it's matured 1845.
I'm sure it would be 1845 or Golden Pride.
I can remember when I tried the 1845, it was a very faint taste. But this one, I'd say it's a stronger taste than.
ABV on. That's a little vinegar. There it is. 6.3. So I don't think it was the 1845. I think it was the what was it? The other one beer that.
Yeah.
I think it was Golden Pride, because Golden Pride's 8.5. So I'm a rough guess. I'm guessing it's Golden Pride the best recipe because it's same ABV. No,
the Golden Pride was a better taste than beer. Yeah. Because I was surprised on that one. It was really nice. You didn't get the same taste you get there. I think it was the 1845.
So you think it was the baseline recipe was the 1845?
Matured a bit.
Not more. I forgot what the other beer was now. Golden Pride. Too much information. So it's either Golden Pride or 1845, the baseline recipe. And they change the recipe every year. Comes in a nice presentation box with detailed writing. But anyway, it is very drinkable. It does have you talking, hence the 10-minute mark.
There we go.
You take care.
And goodbye.
Bye.